I'm doing what I'm doing because I love to do it, and I've been doing it since I was 11, 12. And I will continue doing it for another 50 years, you know. And if people like it, that's a great bonus. But it won't really change the way I do things. But that's what you had for innocence and you and for corruption. There's no way controlling these things, you know. I was brought up in a small country with a lot of attention and brought up with the feeling that everybody know who I am when I walk into a shop. Basically, Sugar Cubes, we're friends since we were children, and we will always be friends. And we are like this, you know, we will always stick together till we die. It's like, let's put it this way, when you were in school, say you were 12 years old, and you were obsessed with, say, insects, in 3 days you would know which kid in the school was obsessed with insects. You would just know. And you would go up to the person and say, hello, we should compare our insect collections.
Do you see your show when you're on stage as some kind of entertainment or as music primary?
I see it as communication. I don't want to analyze it because it would make it very boring for me. Somebody told me that they did a survey and I have all sorts of different fans. I have young people, old people, you know, gay people, straight people, jazz fans, musos, punks, club people, whatever, and I'm very proud of that. Somebody told me that, and I'm very, very proud of that. That shows me at least something I'm doing is right.
But a lot of people see you as a sex symbol.
It comes with my job. I think, say, for example, 100 years ago, if I would be a singer then, pop singer, it was the bottom of the society, it was trashy. And maybe it just happens to be that these days, if you are female and you have a microphone, it's your job, you automatically become a sex monster.
Was it a surprise for you to make it so much abroad, especially in Europe?
Yeah, I mean, I still don't understand it. Because I definitely didn't compromise in any way, you know. But again, we're back into that zone where I just don't know. I can't see myself from the outside. It's impossible for me. I'm mostly educated by my instinct. And at the end of the day, that is the best teacher. Because no two people have the same voices. And no two people need the same teaching, you see. So I've been singing professionally for almost 20 years now.
Shh.